Russia's invasion of Ukraine has forced millions of Ukrainians to leave their homes and seek refuge abroad. The United Nations has called it the fastest growing refugee crisis since World War II.
To those Ukrainians here in the UK, I can tell you we're doing everything we can to help those fleeing the conflict.
Nous prendrons, comme je l'ai dit, notre part et nous protégerons celles et ceux qui arrivent sur notre sol.
We stand with you. Period.
While the West's unprecedented unity and hospitality towards Ukrainians has been applauded, it's also highlighted stark differences in treatment given to refugees from other conflicts.
In 2015, we saw a very different response to the war in Syria. We saw politicians and individuals speaking about people who were seeking protection as if they weren't humans, making us feel like in order to protect our security, we needed to keep them out.
You have the radical Islamic extremists, they're pouring in, they're coming in.
When ISIS say they will use the migrant tide to flood Europe with 500,000 of their own jihadists, I think we better listen.
The reality is for a Syrian refugee and a Ukrainian refugee are wholly different. Ukrainian refugees have been welcomed with open arms in the European Union. With Syria, I think what we've seen is a strategy by European and other states of containing the refugees in the Middle Eastern region and trying to provide support to countries to keep them where they are. Doing deals with countries like Turkey and Libya to try and contain refugees in those countries where we know there have been severe human rights violations against refugees. So with Syria, I think what we've seen is a global response that has been in stark contrast to the response that we have seen in respect of Ukraine. A really important illustration of this is Poland. Poland has accepted the majority of refugees from Ukraine. They are able to live, work, reside, and build a life in Poland. There is a contrast to those refugees from the Middle East, Africa, and Asia. These individuals have been subject to unlawful pushbacks, have been kept in a zone where no humanitarian provision has been allowed.
This is CNN Breaking News. The European Union unanimously agreed to give temporary protection to all refugees fleeing Ukraine, and that gives them protected status and rights to residency.
The Temporary Protection Directive is part of EU law, and it is not new. This essentially allows people who are fleeing from Ukraine to be able to seek sanctuary in countries in Europe, whatever countries they choose. It allows them to work, stay in that country, their children can go to school. In 2015, we had many calling for the European Union to instigate the directive in respect of the refugee flows from Syria. We also saw that again in respect of Afghans in 2021. But what we heard was a hollowing no. Thankfully, we have heard a resounding yes in respect of Ukraine. What Ukraine has showed us is that there is an alternate way of responding to refugees who are in need. Many of our countries who have been the ones rejecting refugees are born off the back of migration and are only enriched by those that come to our countries. What we now need to do is galvanise the public, galvanise politicians, and galvanise the international community as one to ensure that those countries who are often the most in need themselves aren't left with the burden of dealing with refugees.